I'm Sir Tap Tap, and let's play Croixleur Sigma. I have no idea how to pronounce that, and I'm not gonna try ever again. If you speak French, I am sorry. This is a... Well, story isn't very important. This is basically a battle arena sort of game. We're actually gonna play as the secret character, because I prefer weapons a bit more. We'll see what the game is about very shortly. It's easier to show than it is to talk about. One thing annoying about this game, it's almost harder to figure out what weapons you should use than it is to decide on... than to actually, like, play the game. I think it's that one. It's very hard to pick which weapon you want for which special attack. Weapons only matter for the special attack, so it doesn't really matter, and at the very beginning you only have one weapon. That's the one. Okay. Story, honestly, isn't... important. We've got girl one, and we've got probably related girl number two. They have some sort of rocky relationship. But that doesn't matter. This is a game where there are monsters and we kill monsters. That's really all that matters here. The game is on a timer, and, you have MP, which, both to dash and to do special attacks, such as that, or this, you expend MP. MP automatically replenishes pretty quickly, so just dash around like mad, that's how I play. One effect you won't see is the game has... mild but constant tearing. I got used to it pretty quickly. It is a bit annoying, and there's basically no way to fix it. Forcing V-Sync does not seem to work, so I'm not sure what the deal is there. Honestly, Japanese indies have a somewhat spotty record in terms of computer optimization. Like, it's fairly common to end up with minor but noticeable artifacts and stuff like that. Not optimal, but don't kill the game. So, as you go on, you actually find enemies that take more than one hit to kill, and that's where the game starts to get interesting. But for now, I just dash around like mad. The controls in this game are a little weird. You see that cross pattern there? You're meant to map your face buttons like that. I don't do that at all. Because I need instant access to the dash button, to the special attack button, to the jump button, and the attack, normal attack button. So what I do is I have jump on X, square is attack, dash is R1, and special attack is L1. When you do this, you have to memorize which special attack is which, because that cross design there is completely meaningless now. You can remap your controls all you want, but it's not really an ideal setup, in my opinion, because I really don't like the idea of using, you know, all four face buttons for stuff like dash. I really need dash, jump, and normal attack. I really want without moving my fingers at all. And if you use all four face buttons, of course, you have to move your thumb. And that's just not how I prefer to play. This is a problem lots of Mega Man games give me, too. You can almost always remap the controls, but Mega Man X series and Zero and ZX. I think they finally learned to put dash on the shoulder button, but it's been a long and arduous journey before then. So I just always... Yeah, this is the point where special attacks start to matter. Because enemies will take more than one hit, but if you have the right special attack, you can take them down quickly. Also, aerial guides are pretty annoying in this. Basically, all forms of gameplay in this are time attacks, so it really does pay to be able to dash immediately. That is part of why I demand dash be on a, you know, easily accessible button. And partly just because it's really... the movement in this game is very satisfying. You can tilt around the camera. I really prefer not to, just because then it's a little disorienting and distracting. You have to use your, you have to put your thumb over to the analog stick, or, you know, you can map whatever button you want to move the camera, but I just recommend leaving it at a fixed camera angle. And then one thing you will notice is that fairly often you'll end up with enemies towards the front edge of the screen that you've left over, just because that's the easiest part to miss at the default camera angle. So when I can't find anything to kill, I just immediately bolt back to the front of the camera. Oh, and I should explain. When setting up my special attacks, what I usually do is have an all-around attack as my attack. Then for jump, I map an upward strike for anti-air stuff. Then for dash, I match something that, you know, is like a dash attack. And then I put an aerial attack on the bomb that I don't use all that much. That just helps me memorize which one is which attack, because, you know, I don't get the pleasure of using that, you know, intended design of the face buttons, which I just can't personally deal with. Highly recommend playing this with a gamepad. I have not even bothered trying with keyboard controls. I'm sure if you're one of those weird people that absolutely insists on keyboard, no matter what, probably make it happen, but I would personally recommend it. The game even tells you at the startup screen it recommends a gamepad. It's, you know, frantic action game, not a first-person shooter, not an RTS, no particular reason to prefer a keyboard here. I'm personally using a DualShock 4. Plays just fine with the 360 pad because you use the analog, not the D-pad. I guess you could try using the D-pad. I wouldn't particularly recommend it. It's more of a 3D movement than a 2D. You'll notice enemies have different colors, and the color basically signifies how many hits with a normal attack you'll have to do. As we level up, you might not have noticed, but we've been leveling up like mad. I'm not actually sure what leveling up does other than heal us. That may honestly be all it does. There are also these coins we collect. Coins give our invincible attack, you know, those C icons at the bottom left. We earn those from coins. I haven't used any yet. We'll use them as soon as we hit, you know, one of the first boss rooms, probably. Also, score is based on chain and time, basically, and not getting hit. Chain goes up when you collect coins, goes down when you take a hit. It's very possible to just not take hits in this game, and for a high score run, that's basically what you really need to do. And it's also very much a quick bursts of play game. Like, to get the good endings, you need to beat the game in 10 minutes or less. Damn it. And that is entirely possible with a bit of practice and some decent weapons. When you start off, you only have one weapon, and it's not really enough. But some of the bosses you'll want better special attacks with. The main thing I like about this game, the combat, very satisfying. There is really no bullshit aside from setting up the controls, which is, you know, a one-time hassle. And the weapons, you have to figure out, it really does take a minute to sit down and play with the weapons. What I really wish you could do is enter, like, a training mode and just enter the menu, change weapons, screw around, just to figure out what each of them does. Because the description is accurate, but doesn't quite give you the whole story. So you really want to actually use all of the weapons to figure out what they do. To unlock weapons, what you do is whenever there's a... I'll probably see right now. Whenever there's a gate here, and there's two options, if you haven't been to one of the rooms, it shows up as all question marks. And every time you clear an all question mark room, you get a new weapon. Oh, right. Allies. This is one of the boss rooms. the bosses have the shield that isn't too much of a big deal if you have a decent ranged special attack. But what it basically means is they won't get hit stopped properly until that meter disappears, the blue meter there. Ow. And that's bad news if you need to use normal attacks. So what you can do is attack, I usually do two, maybe three if I'm feeling, you know, brave, and then dash away and then dash back in. The dash is an extremely important part of the gameplay, so that's why I map my buttons as I do. Also, aerial enemies are kind of a nuisance, but really not so much that I decide to dedicate too many of my special attacks towards anti-air. I usually just jump and dash at them. Also, with something I'll show you right now. Story thing. Awkward. There's really very little story. It's not an important focus of the game. But normally, you get this three attack chain, and then you have a very large amount of recovery frames. But what you can do, let's let my MP recover. Oh damn, I've taken quite a bit of damage. You can cancel your last attack, or any attack, into a dash if you have MP. MP doesn't recover while you're attacking, by the way. But you can cancel any attack into a dash, and then you can immediately attack again. And that's a really good way to put a lot of pressure on enemies. I should probably use invincibility attacks at some point. The game has an easy mode. I'm not playing on easy mode. I need MP. Unless you're completely opposed to dying, I really recommend just playing on normal mode and getting used to it. It's quite possible you'll die on your first run, but the story mode is so short, it's really not a big deal, so I would really prefer to just die and continue on than, you know, play easy mode and all that crap. I don't even know if you unlock trophy or, you know, achievements. Some achievements do unlock stuff. I'm not sure if level or difficulty level matters at all. As you go on, of course, there are more variety of enemies. Anti-air stuff doesn't really become too important until later on. Like, it's starting to become important now. Also, running away is pretty powerful. Like, very few enemies can catch up to you if you're just walking away. Like, there's no need to dash unless you're already about to be hit. So if you need to take MP, just, you know, take a breather, casually walk away from the enemies, you should be okay. Just do not stop moving, because these wizard guys that I keep targeting, wow. They can be a real pain, because they'll target your stationary position and send down a thunderbolt. Not a problem at all if you're moving. In fact, they'll never hit you if you continue moving. But if you get focused on an enemy and keep using normal attacks, they can hit you pretty easy. Also, there's some non-deliberate monster infighting. I'm not sure if they actually take damage from their own attacks. But some big enemies will hurt other little enemies. Or at least they'll stun them. Like I said, not sure if it hurts them or not. This black swirl attack I use is really good. High damage, area of effect. But it doesn't take effect until about a second after well, not a full second, but, you know, it doesn't take effect until a little bit after you start it. Which can make it dangerous. If an enemy is already starting an attack animation, basically you're gonna take a hit if you start this, you know, after an enemy's attacking. You also seem to get some amount of MP recovered when you collect coins. So if there's tons of coins around, you can just sort of dash through all of them to collect them all in one swoop. Coins do disappear. I've been explaining this game constantly, I haven't had much time to talk about it critically. This is actually the final boss. Story mode, very short, but the game really isn't about just beating it once. It's basically lots of bite-sized fun, and you know, unlock all the weapons, unlock score attack. There's score attack mode and there's challenge mode. I'll show you that in a bit. This guy is what you want to save your invincibility attacks on. There's almost no need to use them before him. There's no reason not to waste all of them on him since he's the final boss, of course. So, I'm sure he's a very challenging final boss and whatever, but I personally see no reason not to just spam all my invincibility attacks on him and get him out of the way. Because he can hurt a lot. So yeah, we just cheesed out the final boss, but whatever. Invincibility attacks are very brief, but you know, if you're invincible, they deal a pretty good amount of damage. Honestly, I have no idea what that achievement was. I'm going to get the true ending, which I didn't on my first, or two actually, playthroughs of this character. It does take a couple times to actually get to the point where you can beat it in 10 minutes, which is what's required. We're so Syndra, it's ridiculous. Let's fight! Yay! No. I probably shouldn't have wasted all of that. Whatever. Wow, you don't have much health. Ow, hey. Rude. Being out of MP is a really bad position to be in. But whatever. She's really pretty easy. Yay, we're like students of some battling thing. I didn't pay much attention to the story, honestly. But they're like friends and stuff, and they kill things. Those are the best kind of friends. Friends can kill people together. Blah blah blah. Also, I forget if I mentioned this. You will not see the vertical tearing or horizontal tearing. The video makes it, you know, a non-issue. It does happen in game though, but it runs at a fluid 60 frames per second. Very, you know, it's completely playable. And I usually hate tearing. I got used to the tearing pretty quickly. It's so consistent that it's very easy to tune out. I think that's what makes it different. Like, I was playing PlayStation Plus users got Bioshock Infinite on PS3 free. Oh my god, it is unplayable with all that tearing. It's awful. But this game, I can definitely stand. Yeah, there's a lot of bathing together talk in both endings, apparently. I'm not entirely sure what that's about. Let's not think too much about that. I'll also show you, there's also a survival mode, there's score attack mode, and there's challenge mode. The challenge mode is, I'm not sure the point of it. They're like incredibly brief trials and there's not very many of them. Score attack is pretty fun, survival mode pretty good. What I like about this game, it's like bite-sized hardcore action. Like, most game sessions will be like 5 to 15 minutes. In fact, there's a timer, you get more time, but like story mode counts down for a 15 minute timer. Yeah, I need to see the credits. We have to see the credits, I can't skip them, I'm sorry. Oh well. Yeah, I really like the combat in this game. I got this from like Build Your Own Bundle on some, I think it was Groupies. With some other stuff. Well, not very many credits at all. Whatever. I'm okay with that then. Oh, my controller decided to disconnect. That's fortuitous timing. Well, I'll be right back. Okay. Now I'm using DS4 to X-Input Mapper 1.1. Hopefully that will last me through the like 5 more minutes of this I want to show you. By the way, you missed this, but by beating that true mode, I unlocked even more stuff. I unlocked arcade mode and bonus mode, survival attack mode, so there's a lot more. Like, the story mode is famously short, but there's a lot more to do here. The challenge mode, let's see if there's any good challenges. Like, the first few challenges were like, let me show you. This was one of the longer ones, which is sad. I really need to remember which one of these I want. This one. Both characters have completely different weapons, by the way. Some of the attacks are similar, but as you can see here, we have an 8-second timer, and it's completely serious. So yeah, not much of a challenge. Well, you have to act really fast, but it's sort of weird. Let's see what one of these harder ones maybe are. I wish it would remember your last weapon setup. That would help a lot. I'm starting to remember which one of the weapons do what. The weapon system's just a bit more clumsy than it feels like it should be. Oh, no, it's still incredibly short. So short that I probably doomed myself by dashing out of the way. I shouldn't have. Oh, no, not quite. These are really just tests of your reflexes more than anything, because they're so brief. Survival mode? Yeah, let's take a look at that. Score attack mode is just, I think it's a 3 seconds, or 3 minutes. Yeah, 3 minutes thing where you get as high a score as you can. It'd be very useful for it to just remember my last sequence. That's why for quite some time I just used the default 4. Survival mode starts off really boring. Lots of single hit kill enemies. These yellow goblins, half the time they just completely ignore you. So aggressiveness is also a different, a trait of higher level enemies. Also, there's some more advanced control options, like, there's one thing that just automatically chains all of your special attacks together, so you just hold the special button and mash attack, basically. That's a good way to, play as a beginner, if you don't want to bother learning it, but the problem with that is they're not going to be optimal, so you'll just have to sort of learn the chain that it presents you and hope that's useful. And there's also control guide or something? There's some sort of control assist thing? I have no idea what that was about. I assumed it was like some sort of super easy mode thing, like, you know how some, fighting games basically set it up so that you can just mash a button and you'll do a moderately long combo? Just automatically? I assumed it was something like that, so I didn't really want it. Also, one thing I really like, since the movement is so fun, even just wailing on single enemies, like single hit enemies like this, can be pretty fun just because you gotta dash to the next, and it's... the movement in this game is very fun. Though it can be a bit finicky because your normal range, or your normal attack is pretty short-ranged. There's also the high score, rankings for like freaking everything. So if you're a high score player, there's definitely a lot extra to do in this. I definitely wouldn't pass this game off just because of the short story mode, because it's quite a lot of action. I can't remember the price exactly. It's on Steam. I'll link you to the Steam store page and any other store page I can find where, developers might get more money. So I usually try to direct people to Humble or to itch.io, just because the developers get a bit more money at the same price. So I mean, If you're paying the same price and the developer gets more money, that's a straight up win in my book. Hey, we have the same attack, I just noticed that. Ow. You should really strive not to take damage even early on in this mode. You do get healed from the level ups, but you can die pretty quickly in this game if you take too much damage at once. I guess that's the definition of dying. Still, it can sneak up on you pretty quick. Especially since I almost never look at the bottom left gauge. I'm pretty much always focused on the middle of the screen. It can be pretty easy to not notice you're about to die. And my first indication of low magic is usually the no MP indicator. So I'm pretty bad at watching the indicators in this game, but I do pretty well anyway, in my opinion. The game does get sort of an awkward lull when you're out of MP. You're just kinda like, oh, stop being awesome for a second, gotta recharge my awesome meter. Yep, that, I meant to do the special bomb. Ow. What? What? Ah. I'm all mixed around on my buttons, sorry about that. Yeah, see, that mistake there, well, it was a few mistakes, but that cost me pretty dearly HP-wise, and then I leveled up, so it doesn't really matter too much, but... You know, it only would have taken a few more hits for me to just flat-out die there. Those red goblins will be often more annoying than actual bosses, because they are complete constant state of aggression, and they actually run up to you pretty often too. Though many, at least this guy, the wolf dude, has a dash attack that can take you by surprise if you're not paying too much attention, which you should be, but whatever. Oh, it actually just says HP plus. Is that because I did the invincible attack, or... I need to not look at that UI because it's gonna be hurt. Oh, now you're being passive. These guys are usually pretty aggressive. They usually. A pretty dangerous attack there. I find this attack, the spin attack, extremely useful because you can sort of kite around. Hey, what? Are you friend or foe? I haven't played enough for this to happen before. Oh my god, she's an enemy. That's not good because she's highly mobile, and that's a recipe for doom. Pretty much always want to target enemies that are highly mobile because they are the ones that will really screw you up. Most enemies, pretty predictable, pretty easy to crowd control. Certain enemies, such as my friend? Sister? I'm not sure what she is. But yeah, she's pretty dangerous when I knocked her out. It's okay. We're friends. Friends beat each other up, right? Right. If you would like to apply to be friends with me, please submit your application to iwillbeatyouup@me.com. Me.com, an actual email provider. Don't email that address. As you can see, survival mode gets pretty packed in, with no lag so far, so that's pretty good. I've got a pretty good PC though. I would like to kill all these bats. I'm not sure I will get the opportunity to get in the air to attack all of these bats. Look at this. I shouldn't have wasted all of those special attacks on my stupid girlfriend slash sister slash whatever the hell she is. Not really sure. I guess I should read the story. There's not much of it. I didn't read it anyway. Too short, didn't read. You can do the invincibility attack in the air, so I'm just going to clear out those stupid bats, because they're getting on my nerves. Why is that one monochrome? It's probably bad. So I think you slowed down slightly when you jumped. Why are you awake again? There's two of you! You're... That... What? No. This is... Quit that. Stop violating the laws of physics. Just stop that. She is on the plus side beating the crap out of everything. I'm not sure it's having all that much effect. Taking more damage than I would care to. Also important, I usually try to dash immediately out of the invincibility attack so I don't get hit immediately after. Ah! Well, that's a new record for me, so not too bad. What the fuck? My controller took... decided that exact moment was the right time to die. Drivers, why aren't you good? But yeah, this is game I can't pronounce. Sigma. It's pretty good. I have no idea what the keyboard controls are. But yeah, there's stats. Not very interesting ones. Achievements. High scores and crap. Assume this is all local. Yeah. So if you want to try and beat my score, be my guest. These are your options. Not too many, predictably. I just max out all this stuff. Yes, but what was it? Control assist. I don't know what that does. I don't really care to find out. Yeah, you can set your keys here. It's a little confusing, honestly. Let's not mess with them, though. But yeah, check it out if you want. Don't if you don't want to. And if you have experience with the DualShock 4 tool, you know, the DS4 to X input mapper thing, let me know, because this is driving me nuts. I guess I'm gonna have to go back to my, surprisingly, my completely unofficial DualShock 3 drivers are the most stable ones currently. The, 360 used to be pretty reliable, but then it decided to just not hold a charge.